Okay, this sermon is entitled, Calvinists Need to Get Saved. I'd like to open up with prayer, and then with a few verses. Dear God, thank you for giving us your clear word. Thank you for allowing us to see what it says. Bless the listeners. I ask all this in Jesus' name, amen. Psalm 139 reads, O Lord, thou hast searched me and known me. Thou knowest my down-sitting and mine uprising. Thou understandest my thought afar off. Thou compassest my path and my lying down, and art acquainted with all my ways. Now, I've heard people claim over the years that Calvinists are saved, and that they just got mixed up sometime subsequent to salvation, and we should refer to them as brothers and sisters in Christ. And this may be the case with some Calvinists, but I believe that most Calvinists are unsaved, and that's the reason they fell for Calvinism. Because unsaved people will believe anything. And in Calvinism, there's a counterfeit version of every facet of true Christianity, aka free grace. So instead of deluding ourselves that most Calvinists are saved, we need to treat them as unsaved prospects for evangelism. So now let me go into my notes and prove that Calvinists have a false rendition of everything found in true biblical Christianity. Number one, they have a false eternal security. Now, in free grace theology, we believe in unconditional eternal security. Jesus said in John 6:35, I am the bread of life. He that cometh to me shall never hunger, and he that believeth on me shall never thirst. And in Calvinism, they have a conditional security. The Calvinist will tell you that in that same verse that I just quoted, that the word believe means to continue believing. So you have to continue to drink the water of life in order to never thirst. And see, that would render the water of life physical water. It has no divine properties. Whereas in biblical Christianity, Jesus offers eternal water that upon one drink, your thirst will be forever slaked. So in Calvinism, they don't have true eternal security. They have conditional security. When it comes to grace, in free grace theology, grace is offered to every single person freely. In Calvinism, grace is irresistibly forced on the elect. In free grace, we believe that faith is without works, and that you put your faith alone in Christ alone for salvation. In Calvinism, faith is a work, and faith would be a work if it has to continue. And I have a quote by a renowned Calvinist that proves that they believe that faith is a work. It reads, faith itself is man's act or work and is thereby excluded from being any part of his justifying righteousness. So according to this stupid unsaved Calvinist, we're not justified by faith alone because according to him, faith is a work. Moving on to my next point, in free grace, we believe in the true Jesus, who is the Savior of the world. In Calvinism, they have a false Jesus, who is the Savior of only some people, aka the elect. In free grace, we have objective assurance based on what Jesus did for us. In Calvinism, they have subjective assurance. That's why they're constantly looking to themselves to ratify their so-called election. In free grace, our literary source is the Bible alone. In Calvinism, they go by creeds, confessions, and Calvinistic quotes. And then finally, in free grace, our final destination is heaven, whereas in Calvinism, their final destination is hell because they trusted in their self and they had another Jesus and another gospel and they embraced an artificial form of Christianity. So that's all I have. Calvinists need to get saved, and they're saved the same way anyone else is, and that is by believing on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. And even in Calvinism, they reject that simple truth because they think that man can't believe, and that if you do, it's an act of your free will and a work. They also think that faith must continue, and that you have to persevere to the end, and that if you don't have works, then you didn't have faith to begin with, And all of this is just another gospel that leads people straight to hell. And that's exactly where Calvinists are going if they don't get saved. So that's all I have. Let me go ahead and close in prayer. Dear God, thank you for giving us your clear word. Thank you for allowing us to see what it says. Bless the listeners. I ask all this in Jesus' name, amen.